I had almost given up on getting this brake drum loose. This is a 1998 Chrysler Town & Country Minivan Generation III. Put penetrating oil on it. I beat on it occasionally with a 5-pound hammer. And even put a torch to it, but I'm a little careful about heating things, so that didn't do any good. Then I went online and saw the puller that a fella had made. I'll try to get the link to his site on my web page. So finally, after the penetrating oil had soaked for a few days and I had beat on it and pulled on it, and I hooked this up and used a 10-pound hammer. Put some tension on the puller and hit it several strong blows with the 10-pound hammer. And it came loose. Now I've got to pull it sort of slip over the brake shoes. There's something in there dragging. And watch the seconds go. I'm going to back off on the automatic adjuster to get to release some of the tension on the return spring. And that will make it easier to take the return spring loose. Then I'll hold the shoes back a little bit and take the cylinder out. So you can use the screwdriver to move that adjuster out of the way and start rotating toward the top. Maybe easier said than done. There it goes. Okay, you can stop the recording. Alright, now I'm going to take this little retention clip out. I don't know what it's for, but let's see if it'll come out. Okay, stop it. You ready?
Go.
Okay, so I'm pushing down, moving that clip off. Okay, that's it. Stop it. Okay, tell me when you start.
Okay.
Okay, I'm using these needle nose vise grips. I'm trying not to squeeze the band, although I think I'm going to put a new spring in anyway. All right. This can be a little hard to do. I'm going to put a screwdriver up here to help pull it out when I... There it goes. Okay, that's it. Tell me when it's going.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now I should be able to move the shoes back a little bit. And watch, this adjuster can slip out of its little place. So be careful with those and watch where they are. All right, so the, can you see this little tab right here? It sticks right, it doesn't refocus, so you have to stay the same distance away. That little tab goes up in a notch in this bracket. All right, the cylinder is ready to go. You can turn that part off. Okay, the brake line is 11 millimeters. And that's all of that one.
Wait a minute.
Okay, the bolts are 3/8. Okay, that should be enough. Cylinder has...
Wait.
The cylinder is 13/16 internal diameter. The bleed screw is 8 millimeters. Okay, that's enough for now. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, all right. So the mounting holes weren't threaded all the way down, and so I had to grind off part of the threads at the tips of these mounting bolts. And if you don't have a grinder, that could be hard. It's just fortunate that I do. So you might want to take it back if you find a situation like that. Okay, that's it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to push the shoes back up and being very careful to see that everything stays in its place, especially this automatic adjuster. I'll pull it up in just a second. Okay. All right. I think looks like everything's back in place. Okay. Now I have to put the return, you don't have it going, do you?
Yes.
It is? Okay, I'll have to put the return spring back in. Okay, stop that.
Go.
All right. Putting in a new spring, normally I just reuse the old one, but I had two because the set came with enough for both wheels. Little triangular hole back there, you can see where the springs were. And I'll use the needle nose vise grips with just slight pressure on them. And my knee for leverage, and hope that I can get it up there, because it can be hard to do. I put that rope on there to keep the shoes still while I do this. Let me back off some. Okay, I think, why don't you stop it and then start it again. Got it. Okay. There's that. I'm gonna bring this little clip up. Put it back on there. I don't know what it's for, but it's there. Okay. That's it. Now to bleed them. That's all. Okay, I backed off the adjuster. And so there's too much space between the drum and the shoes. So now I need to tighten the adjuster. And you go down to tighten. And I backed off a whole bunch, so I may have to move it a long way. Can you see what I'm doing there? I'm holding this thing out of the way and turning that. It goes down in this side to tighten. I don't film the whole thing. I think I've adjusted it up enough now to get the shoes to be a snug fit. Well, maybe not. I usually like to feel a little drag, so stop it again. I believe I've tightened it enough. You hear just a little bit of a drag. I had the